ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंशर्षभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। मे द ऑलमाइटी श्री लॉर्ड वेंकटेश्वर बेस्टो ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी गुड हेल्थ वेल्थ एंड इटर्नल हैप्पीनेस विद पोटेंशियल पावर एंड पूर्ण परिपूर्ण रूपेण लक्ष्मी कटाक्षम्स टू यू एंड द एंटायर योर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड फ्रेंड्स। लेट अस बिगिन भगवद्गीता। We have completed 11th chapter with the help of, with the blessings of Lord Venkateshwara and the Bhagavad Gita, which contains 18 chapters. We can also take the examples of a temple. You know, a temple is a unique construction. Because the India is full of temples, every temple has got a different, means a unique system. It depends on the deities which is established in the Sanctum Sanctorum, which we call it Garbhagraha. The Garbhagraha deity is the main deity. The deity which exists in the Garbhagraha is going to be the main deity. From Gopura to the Sanctum Sanctorum, there are, you know, many praharas. Praharas means the circles which you can see in few temples, 3 or 5. In certain temples, only one praharas will be there. It's a unique construction. Any construction in this world, it needs to have the foundation. And that foundation, the depth of the foundation, the width and depth and the deep of foundation, it depends on how high the building is going to be. Because the skyscrapers, it needs a long, deep foundation. Those foundations are very much valid for construction in the same way. The Shastra, which is known as Bhagavad Gita, is a construction. That construction also is a unique construction like the temple. The temple which nourishes all the people physically, psychologically, causal level. In the same way, in the conscious level, the construction which helps us to set or establish ourselves in the Sanctum Sanctorum calls Shastra's construction. Now, Bhagavad Gita is the construction, the who is going to be the deity, that nothing but you, who is experienced in the form of I. You may think, I cannot be a God. You need not be the God, because the godliness which exists, it doesn't depend you, my dear. Whether you accept or deny, it doesn't matter. You are nothing but God, because you have everything what Ishvara has. You have everything what the world is. Therefore, this construction, which is known as the Bhagavad Gita, the foundations are nothing but 10 chapters. You know, all this according to the Vastu philosophy, according to Agama system, or Vaidika system, or Tantrika system, whatever the systems which are required for that concerned temple. This construction, which is very unique, it works from the level of physical and psychological and causal system, which we also divided in sthula, sukshma, karana, sharira, and pancha bhutani, prapanchaha. So all this entire jagat becomes the construction for a soul which is known as atma. The entire creation is the construction. That construction is explained here. When you study the Bhagavad Gita, then you can understand how it works. So take a temple as an example. So temple has got the foundation, okay? And all other, you know, from the compound, because every temple which has got the compound which is prolonged, means the height of the compound is more than a normal house compound, because, you know, outside environment, any temple you go and see, from the compound to the Garbhagraha, there are so many praharas, so many deities around, and there are dwarapalakas, means the door securities. So it's in a different way, it is also known as a castle, a court, or it is known as what is the kingdom alone. In the same way, this Shastra is the construction. The foundation and compound have been raised. Now all the construction has been completed. The 11th chapter is going to be the dome of the Sanctum Sanctorum. Do you know what we call in Sanskrit? It's known as Vimana. Garbhagraha Vimana. So every deity, they have a different varieties of Vimana. There are numbers of innumerable Vimana systems, you know. So if you might have seen Tirupati Balaji's Vimana is something different. Ranganatha Vimana, something is different. The Parthasarathi's temple which is in Chennai, it has got different Vimana. That Vimana is nothing but the 11th chapter of the temple which is known as Bhagavad Gita. And the main deity which is nothing but your consciousness you are going to establish. Means you are going to identify yourself as the Moola Vigraha, the Garbhagraha Vigraha. That's what the beauty of Bhagavad Gita. So like that, these 10 chapters, so which provided a proper foundation for us to set a proper Divya Drishti. What is known as Divya Drishti means a special vision which was provided to Arjuna by Krishna, and which was even provided to Sanjaya by Vyasacharya. And this Divya Drishti means what? A vision with knowledge. We can call it a vision with wisdom. So we pursue the world, we see the world. World has been manifested because when we were born, world was there before itself. Then we continue with the world which exists before my birth, thinking that this world is eternal. I am born now. Now I am temporary soul because I am going to die soon. The world will exist forever. The eternity is seen in the world, which is very wrong perception to have. We live with it. Now entire Bhagavad Gita changes. Now you are eternal. This world is going to be non-eternal. The world which always undergoes the death means modification. You are other than modified world, means you are the extraordinary one. Now this understanding needs lots of pre-work, my dear. Those pre-works have been done from past 10 chapters, especially the first 6th chapter, which removes all kinds of ignorance about a person's self. Then from chapter 7, Bhagavan has began to unfold the vision of wisdom slowly, 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 slowly. Because the God alone has evolved the world, means what? In order to see the God, you need not to separate yourself or God from the world. For that, you need to have a Divya Drishti. And a Divya Drishti means what? It's a special vision with proper understanding. That proper understanding which needs for attitudinal change. What exactly the attitudinal change? Because when you have the normal attitude with the objects, you know, usually we see with a normal vision which has got normal attitude. Normal attitude means what? World exists, that I am also existing in the world. So I have to interact with the world for my needs. That's what the normal understanding. So normal understanding, if I have given the example, you have to remember. So when somebody provides laddu, so you take the laddu and you are about to eat, and that person gives one more information. So So you know that this laddu is from Tirupati Tirumala from Balaji. When I am informed this knowledge, then my understanding changes. That different understanding brings a kind of extraordinary attitudinal change. That extraordinary attitudinal change brings a different perception. That perception makes me a completely different person. Laddu remains as the laddu. Now he can see as the prasada. That prasada is not existing in the laddu, that exists in his buddhi. That buddhi itself is a fortunate buddhi. That buddhi becomes prasada buddhi. Then when he swallows or takes that laddu, he feels and experiences that Balaji's vision itself, darshan itself. In the same way, somebody brings a bat and he says, "Do you want this bat?" "I don't know what bat means." "I'm telling about a cricket bat." And he said, "Okay, I don't want to take this bat. Do you know the bat from whom?" He said, "I don't know. This bat, the Tendulkar's bat." So in which he made 10 centuries. Now your eyes goes, wide enough. Oh my God. How drastically I need this bat. This is what attitudinal change in normal life. And piano from Beethoven. So the piano which he used, your understanding changes, and because of that understanding, attitude change. Now to see the world as the world, you need not to have a different perception, different attitude. When you have normal understanding with the world and with normal attitude, world and you go both together, your suffering also take place. But world will remain the same, but your understanding gives a special stage. Means I'm saying the understanding from Shastra, that Shastra's understanding will bring a different attitudinal change. May the world remain the same, but you could have a vision with wisdom, which with you can have the freedom's experience. You become Mukta Purushaha. You are called Jivan Muktaha. You are known as the Virat Bhaktaha. But to become Jivan Muktaha, we need to have one more step, which is known as Arupa Bhakti. But Bhagavan here talks about the world and you, the connection between world and you. World is nothing but God. Therefore, Bhagavan, he prepared us. He didn't say in the beginning chapter alone. In the second chapter, he doesn't talk about Vishwarupa Darshana. In the second chapter, he doesn't even discuss about Ishvara Swarupam. From seventh chapter, he begins to give the definition for Ishvara Swarupa. The nature of Ishvara is what? The nature of Ishvara is nothing but cause of entire universe. He is the cause of universe. He is the cause of creation. The what kind of cause? Because any object needs two kinds of causes. One is known as material cause, another is known as intelligent cause. So which causes Bhagavan is? Because material cause, it has got limitations. Intelligent cause, it has got its own limitations. Now Bhagavan becomes both intelligent and material cause. The material aspects of the God's nature is being discussed in this chapter. Of course, that even material cause is being unfolded properly with the help of intelligent cause. Now, God is both Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana Ishvaraha. The 11th chapter is a Gopuram, I tell you. It's a Vimana, it means it's a supreme. When you do Kumbhabhisheka, this Kalasha Tirtha alone, it makes a temple, a sanctum sanctorum, into a temple. From that Kalasha, you have Darbha grass, a kind of, we bring the thread of Darbha grass. then we connect with the main deity. That main deity is nothing but you, or the temple which is known as Bhagavad Gita. Wherever you go in front of a deity, which is a main deity in Garbhagraha, you have to identify your consciousness with that deity. That's the glory of Sanatana Dharma. See, it's traveling to Lord Venkateshwara, traveling to Badrinath Ishwara, traveling to Ranganatha. When you go there, traveling to Kailash, even whole traveling belongs outside factor to identify yourself with the Bhagavan, the deity. When you go in front of the deity, you close the eyes and you feel something. Where do you feel? What do you feel? And what is happening? What kind of experience that you get? You observe and you observe. Both happens. That's what this 11th chapter is. A very beautiful but very important. This is going to be a dome. And the remaining chapter, which is going to deal with the sanctum sanctorum. And the God will be found in the form of nothing but your nature, original nature. It's a beautiful process which is known as Bhagavad Gita. The clear vision. The first, the Divya Chakshu means what? It's extraordinary attitudinal change. This extraordinary attitudinal change brings change in your life. World remains normal world, but you gain proper thing what to be gained by human being. But the fact is, world is nothing but Ishvara alone. You will start experiencing that. For that you need to have myth or miracle. In fact, the birth itself miracle. So everything is nothing but God. That understanding. For that alone, Bhagavan prepared us from the chapter number 7. 7, 9, 10. These three chapters, they gave a kind of maturity for us to have a Divya Drishti. Then he came to this Vishwarupa Darshana. So we have learned in the 7th chapter itself what can be understood in three stages or three steps. So what are they? First, God is to be understood as the material cause. Not only that, the material cause which is backed up by Nimitta Karana, which is known as intelligent cause. God is to be understood both cause. Like the given example in Shastra is spider. So when spider creates a web, that net which it brings from its saliva, the material comes from its own. The same way when God creates the world, God, the material brings from the God alone. That's the first level of understanding. God exists in Kailasha, Vaikuntha or somewhere. That is the first level of understanding. When you grow to understand it, at that time, the next understanding should take place. God alone has evolved. There is nothing called Vaikuntha or Kailasha other than the world creation. Now, when God has evolved the world, in order to see the God, you need not break the world. You need not to work separately for that to see the God. When you see any form, that any form is nothing but the manifestation of the God alone. To make us understand that Bhagavan worth a lot, you need not to have a separate effort to look. You have to bring a proper attitudinal change. That's it. That's what Bhagavan has given as a Divya Drishti. Then he started explaining about himself. From verse number 5 to 8, Bhagavan just explains that who am I? I am nothing but, you know, both causes. Like the gold ornament has been manifesting as a bangle, chain, ring, or there are so many pendants, you know, ornaments are there. All of them, they appear as though they are different in form and names. But if you have the perception of a gold, then all those ornaments are just the different name and form of a one material. In the same way, the furnitures, when you look at a furniture which is made of wood, So you can have two kinds of perception. If you pursue through the angle of name and form, the table is different than the bench. Bench is different than the desk. Desk is different than the stool. Stool is different than the ladder. But when you have the perception, the angle of perception from the standpoint of wood, all of them are one, but appearing in different form. It means what? The wood need not to manifest or create itself again to convert itself as a bench. Being in the form of stool, being in the form of chair, being in the form of ladder, it continuously existing as the causal form. In the same way, the world exists in the form of Ishvara, means Ishvara alone appears to be in the form of name and form, different name and form. That is the clarification from Bhagavan's standpoint. The first Varnana, the explanation, the expression about Bhagavan's nature, he himself gives verse number 5 to 8. Then Sanjaya begins. That's what beauty is. Now the narration of Bhagavan's Swarupa from mouth of Bhagavan, then from the mouth of Sanjaya, from the mouth of Arjuna. Now the God alone, when he explains about himself, it is given in the normal meter. But even Sanjaya, when he explains, it looks like a normal meter, means anushtup chandas. But when Arjuna begins, okay, then the meter is changed. Something happens. So what is that something? When God is understood as Vishwarupa, it's a great thing to happen in your life, because the gap between world and me alone makes my life into hell. Now that is being changed. When Bhagavan says, Ihai kastham jagat krishnam pashyadya characharam, you can see in me the entire creation. That's what the meaning is. So like the space which it becomes a substratum of all object. It's a unique expression, you know. Unique expression, but we were prepared in the beginning itself. Therefore, this chapter, 11th chapter especially, it's a special chapter. We have to have proper mahavalokana. Just I began to summarize the chapter, but this summarization should help us to assimilate the content of this chapter. That's what my intention is. Because this chapter alone, the main chapter in Bhagavad Gita, if this chapter is being understood properly, then you can realize the forthcoming chapters which deals with Arupa Ishwaraha. So when the Virat Ishwaraha, means Vishwarupa Ishwaraha, is understood, all the complications, conflicts will be gone with the soul. Then the jiva becomes a pure raga dvesha rahita. Because always we have dislikes and dislikes, you know, raga dvesha and kama, krodha, moha, madha, matsyari. All kinds of these conflicts will be removed. Your chitta will become nirmalatvam. Then he brings bhakti. When you are able to conquer raga dvesha, then bhakti will take place. Excellent process, isn't it? We will continue with the blessings of Lord Venkateshwara to summarize, I mean assimilate the 11th chapter. I will finish it, you know, in one or two sessions, maybe in one session, who knows, you know, session. Then we will go to bhakti yoga. With the Lord Venkateshwara's blessings and glory, we will just assimilate completely the knowledge of this Bhagavad Gita. Harihi Om. See you in the next session. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम।